Well, hi, it's Kurt once again, and we're here today with our day of devotion. And today's study is on 1 Corinthians, and we're in 1 Corinthians 9. I know, it's crazy, right? We made it all the way to chapter 9. And it's a simple one here, and it's called, you should support and pay your ministry staff. So, you know, cards on the table, I'm an unpaid minister, right? That's what I currently do. In addition to my regular job working for a big company, I am currently an unpaid minister on staff at a small inner city church, which I chose. And this is also based on 1 Corinthians 9, which we'll get to later. But this same chapter also advocates for paying your staff and paying them a decent wage. 1 Corinthians 9, 11, and this is all the way through 14, says this: since we planted spiritual seed among you, aren't we entitled to a harvest of physical food and drink? If you support others who preach to you, shouldn't we have an even greater right to be supported? But we've never used this right. We'd rather put up with anything than be an obstacle to the good news about Christ. Don't you realize that those who work in the temple get their meals from the offerings brought to the temple? And those who serve at the altar get a share of the sacrificial offerings. In the same way, the Lord ordered that those who preach the good news should be supported by those who benefit from it. And if you read like verses 1 through 10, the previous verses all support this. Make sure your vocational ministers are paid well enough so they don't have to take second jobs, which means you need to give as God has intended. My own take on this and why I'm an unpaid minister will come in a later devotional. Our theme verse for this whole section has been 1 Corinthians 2, 1 and 2, which says, when I first came to you, dear brothers and sisters, I didn't use lofty words and impressive wisdom to tell you God's secret plan. For I decided while I was with you, I'd forget everything except Jesus Christ, the one who was crucified. This whole thing of paying your staff well, I participate in a couple of forums, and I hear often about staff members, especially at smaller churches, who are making barely livable wages, who in some cases are forced to even take Medicaid and so on and so forth to get by. And I find it to be very depressing. And I just would encourage you to not allow that to happen at your church. Let's pray together, and then let's head out for our day. Father, we're thankful for your love. We're thankful for our ministers, and we're thankful for those people who devote their lives to bringing people the gospel, bringing me the gospel. I'm thankful for people like Carl and Rich and others who have told me about Jesus. And I'm thankful for the ones that I know today. And fortunately, Father God, I know I work in a church where the staff members are paid well. And Father, I'm thankful that that has happened in the church I am involved in. But Father, I pray for the other ministers that aren't as well paid. And I pray that they will be well compensated so they can be proud, and so they can also live, and so they can also support their families. And I know they love you so much. I know you love them too. And Father, I pray that their congregations will love them enough to pay them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, not all of them are uppers. Have a great day. We'll talk to you later. Bye.